People notice Florence. She's got presence, like you had, though not for the same reasons as you. Florence isn't refined. People noticed you, and though we were the same, somehow there was more of you. You could swim all the way to the other side of the Maribyrnong River. I was only game enough to go to the end of the jetty. Any rate, when she showed up last week, I took one look at her and thought, I don't want you sitting on my toilet seat or washing your body in my bath any more than I want to go to a home and use towels thousands of strangers have rubbed all over their bits. As I say, I tried to live with Florence, gave it a whole week, but we argued from the first day. Firstly, she ate the last chocolate in the box. My birthday present from Walter. Didn't ask, just took it and popped it in her mouth. I don't usually like sweets, she said, but these are nice. Then she refused to do the dishes. While I eat my tea, I like to watch the news on the television. So at 6 o'clock, I sit in my chair with my cold ham salad on my stable table to watch the news. She came and sat in Lance's chair. Being hospitable, I offered her something to eat, and she asked for poached egg on toast, which she ate standing at the kitchen bench. I ate a steak sandwich standing at the bar for 50 years, she said. Quite reasonably, I suggested she do the dishes since I cooked her tea. But she just said, We'll do the dishes in the morning, eh, love?